Camera set. Hopefully this time one of the GoPros will not die on me, and if so, then just another GoPro. But in any case, good morning, comrades. Welcome back to the channel.
Previously, we did a lap with a M140i 500 horsepower rear-wheel drive, and now we are having here a BMW M140i, slightly less horsepower, 450, right?
Yes, 450.
First of all, hello, how are you doing?
Thank you, very good.
And also thank you very much for this opportunity for letting me drive this car. There's more to it in a bit, but tell us more about it. Like, so it's xDrive, 140, 450 horsepower.
Yes.
Is this dynoed already?
Or not dynoed.
Okay.
I have a display in the car, it says 450 horsepower.
Okay, okay.
Yeah. It's a straight pipe, downpipe.
Yeah.
It's got a BCS power valve exhaust,
uh-huh.
Where
the valve
is, yeah, permanently open.
Okay.
And I put a ProTrack wheels on it.
Nice.
It's 9.5 inches wide, yeah. 18 inch. It's 255-35 Nankang AI1 tires.
Nice.
And it's a square setup.
Oh, cool.
Yeah,
yeah, that's good for the, obviously for xDrive, the driver's square setup. What brake?
It's an MMR performance brake kit, 380. Millimeters,
okay.
Six piston calibers,
and the pads you're running,
EBC RPX.
Okay, good,
yeah.
Nice.
Right, well, I guess usually I would say we together hop in and do a lap, but actually in this case there is no passenger seat, so I'm entrusted to go out all by myself, for which, what I was referring to in the intro, it's quite special to do a lap. So, thank you very much.
Proper ring tool.
Actually, there's also some stiffening of the car.
Okay.
Is that too nerdy?
Oh, no, you can tell me, yeah, for sure.
Yeah, in the...
We didn't even talk about the suspension, actually.
The suspension is Bilstein B8 passive damper.
Okay.
With H&R lowering springs.
Okay.
I got an Ultra Racing strut brace here.
Uh-huh.
With adjustable camber plates from
Racing. Yeah,
yeah, from Millway in Sweden.
Cool.
And then in the back, removed the back seat.
Yeah.
Saved 35 kilos of weight.
Nice. And a bracing.
And a bracing from K-Brace in England. And in the rear, I removed some plastic and the wiper.
Oh, cool.
And I put a lithium max battery for 20 kilos of weight saving.
Wow. Yeah, so it's made lighter, but still a lot of it's... You can go even crazier.
It's probably around 80 kilos of weight, yeah, saved.
Nice, nice, very cool. Well, I'm gonna see how it feels like.
Yeah, enjoy your lap.
Yeah, thank you.
Welcome into the car park. Let's go for a lap. Very excited. Again, hoping that the GoPro is recording now. A lot of people said like, hey, you should have like a high-speed memory card. I have. I just have to buy them every like half a year because otherwise they keep on expiring or breaking or something. In any case, Peter told me to put it in sport drive, wait, not in sport drive, but in sport plus, and then DSC completely off. With the xDrive, I kind of trusted. With that car over there, that was kind of sketch. So sport plus, then DSC off, keep it pressed for 5 seconds. Yeah, and now it says actually off. So let's see, it's gonna be very interesting to experience this car. This goes in my pocket, not in the cup holder. To experience this car, because as mentioned, last year we had the BMW M240xDrive for drag racing build, 500 wheel horsepower. And Toyo R888R tires, but for the rest, pretty much stock when it comes to suspension components. It was just like, in a way, undrivable. The car ahead of us has also 500 horsepower, not on the wheels, I guess, but only on the back. And also because of the power delivery, it's sketchy. This one, all-wheel drive, so... Yes! And look, rear-wheel drive is going away from us. mighty Dacia Sandero. Fiat Panda. This drives so much more confidence inspiring than the other car. A bit of traffic on the fast section of Schwedenkreuz, that's too bad, but hey, it's important to stay safe. But my god. It's actually, the car is very forgiving with the xDrive and also air ones all around it. Works very well. You can just floor it and out of the corner. Perfect. Traffic. It's kind of unfortunate. That guy in front of us, Max, is very fast, so not gonna try to keep up with him with a car that I don't know, even though that it might have more horsepower. I don't know if he's running S54 or not, but he's like doing sub 730s, maybe even even sub 720s. I don't remember, like, but I know he was like one of the fastest guys with the E36. Fun. That was proper fun. And big shout out to the guy behind me in the M2 competition. Don't know the plate, doesn't look familiar, so I don't know who exactly it is, but also very fast driving. Ah. Well, I guess I might as well do an outro here. Amazing car. I was really surprised because this one hit the sweet spot. I mean, as mentioned, first we drove the X-Drive version, which was drag modified, then the other one that had too much power for the rear wheels only. Maybe if you could run wider tires, maybe different alignment settings, we shouldn't go too much into detail. But this one, you just hop in and go. DSC fully off, keep the pedal to the metal, and the car just goes. You don't have to be afraid of like too much of a snappy oversteer. Because also this we drove in Sport Plus, just like the other yellow car, and no issues at all. Also big brake kit contributed to more confidence. It's very nice. It's definitely very nice. Of course, it has some limitations because like on some certain sections of the track, you'll be like, you would want to have the suspension, which was good, but suspension dialed in actually for the track. This means like actually because this is like a fixed damper B8 from Bilstein, but if you could have some adjustments like a one-way, two-way, three-way, doesn't matter how many ways, and modify it accordingly to this car, and then the next step would be aero for these high-speed sections. But overall, wow, it's really good. Like this could be, to an extent, I wouldn't say a beginner's car, but like from all the modern hot hatches, this car is very forgiving because it is actually very neutral when it comes to steering. So it does not understeer. Of course, it understeers more than a rear-wheel drive car, but in comparison, it does not understeer too much. It does not oversteer or the snappy oversteer. But of course, we have to thank it also to the current setup. It's not completely stock, but yeah, as said, it's good. So thank you very much, Peter. Hope you enjoyed watching this video of me driving your car, or like was not too scared. But it's very nice. Like obviously a couple of mistakes from my side here and there. Yeah, we were just like having a playful, thoughtful playtime or playful thought time. That could be a segment on my channel or something. But no, it was lots of fun, and if I could go another time, another go, yeah, then you obviously get used to the car, see how it behaves, but it's fun. It's really fun. So also you guys, I hope you guys enjoyed, and see you in tomorrow's video when I don't know what's gonna happen, but probably something on the Nürburgring. Oh no, we have to go straight so we can do some car spotting on the car park as we are here. Shout out to the RS4 ahead of us from Finland, Cage behind. The Schmies Black Series that's gathering all the crowd. Really good.
It's okay.
Yeah, yeah. I loved it. Like from the three M140s I drove, this was the best one. Okay. This hit the spot.
Nice.
Really good.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's no, thank you. Like enjoyed it a lot. It's very cool.
Thank you.